I've never been anywhere really that doesn't look like this. I've never been to a forest, nor to the Arctic, to a real beach. Never seen wild flowers or green grasses growing in a meadow. It's only ever been the wasteland. Yes, we've traveled the world over. The skies burn themselves bare with coppery blues and greens, or else simmer under a lid of noxious clouds. The landscape is ochre on ochre. What few plants remain are usually scorched and scrubby. A straggle of brown and burnt umber thatching the earth. Spindles of ginkgo tree and spears of aspen offering up scant smatterings of shade. Pools and bugs churn underfoot, dust thickening into mud. But not a drop of water out there worth a damn. Like I said, it all looks the same. The cleanest place I've ever seen is the Great Desert. Miles and miles of rolling sand, golden sand, none of it blackened, none of it fused into sickly grey nuclear glass. But beyond the Great Desert lies a place like no other. Now, I tell you, fellow traveller, the tale of the otherworldly place. All your earthly possessions slung across the hump of a strange beast. You cross the Great Desert. Drinking dry the last dregs from your flask, you feel the burn, but by some miracle, burning from the heat, not the prickle of radiation. You've come to the caravansary. In you'd crawl. Through those tall gates. Safe. And sheltered. At long last. Food and drink. Exotic wares, the sheens of silk and bales of cotton, scented tendrils of spice. People from every creed and every tribe passing through. Bartering not just their goods, but their ideas and their stories. Can you imagine such a place? I can, you know. I can. That's what Old Town was to us. Our caravansary. Our oasis, our shelter in the desert. The traveler's rest, which makes the pilgrimage worthwhile. No sheiks or wizards, but we had our journeymen, our knights, our warriors, barterers, traders too. There's more things between Old Town's four walls than I'd ever thought possible in heaven or on earth. Colors like you will never see. Reds, brighter than blood, blues, deeper than that toxic oxidized sky, browns, richer than our planet's pallid crust, greens that will never wilt or fade, no matter how much or how little it rains, oranges, warm, sweet, citrusy, not the shade of cooling ember. The sounds, not since the end of the old world, have so many human voices laughed, cried, and sang together. Foreign tongues curling around peculiar words, disparate voices, all patching together their histories, their memories, the fragments of their own cultures into the strangest melody. Then there is, of course, the way it would shine, the way it would glitter, like nowhere else it could in these plains of dust and mud. That gleam of metal, when you scrape away its rusty skin to tinker with the systems beneath, the glistening metallic guts of the old tech, the glinting sinews of the machine, the unchangeable bones of the artificial beast. That's how it would glitter. Even after all these years, even though I know I can't return yet, I still hear it calling out to me.
It has a voice. A town can have a voice. Maybe you can hear it too.
Close your eyes, hear the voice within, calling. This heavy load got under your skin, howling. You got the white knuckles holding on a tight, keeping your feelings bottled up inside. Heading for a collision in the night. To really live, you gotta die. Breathe in, breathe out. Hey, come, come, come alive. Breathe in, breathe out. Look at the colors, colors, colors. Right.
Your doubts, there's a heart going.